हे गाइस, वेलकम बैक टू द चैनल। मैंने अपनी एक वीडियो में बताया था कि संडे को मैं आने वाली हूँ द कैनेडियन होम के ऑफिस और मिलने वाली हूँ उनके ब्रोकर ऑफ रिकॉर्ड से, और आप अपने क्वेश्चंस भेजो। बहुत सारे क्वेश्चंस आए हैं मुझे, थैंक यू सो मच, आप मेरी हर वीडियो पे एक्ट करते हो। तो उन सारे क्वेश्चंस में से मैंने टॉप 20 क्वेश्चंस लिए हैं पूछने के लिए। तो हम हैं मिस्टर मनोज जी के साथ, ही हैव 20 ईयर्स ऑफ रियल एस्टेट एक्सपीरियंस इन कैनेडा। आई विल आस्क हिम टू फर्स्ट इंट्रोड्यूस हिमसेल्फ और फिर हम आएंगे क्वेश्चंस पे। Thank you so much for having us here.
Thank you, Shilpa.
Okay, so if quickly you can give us your introduction.
Hi, everyone. Like, my name is Manoj Kharata, and like Shilpa said, we're in the industry almost 20 years now, and now broker of record of the Canadian Home, and we are doing well right now, and all over Ontario our presence is there, and we have a really, really good app, the Canadian Home. You can download that app from Play Store or App Store. So that's where we are.
I have told you about the Canadian Home app in my previous video. I'll link the video link in the description box. और app के बारे में भी हम लोग आगे और भी बात करने वाले हैं कि क्या Canadian Home app है और क्यों आजकल वो मेरी favorite app है. But उससे पहले we'll take out the questions. तो in no order कि ये question best था तो मैंने number 1 पे लिया और ये question best नहीं था या फिर okay था तो मैंने number 20th पे लिया. All the questions you have sent me are very interesting questions. Trust me, I have chosen the best 20 and every question is very important if you have plans to land in Canada, buy a home in Canada, rent a home in Canada or sell a home in Canada. चलिए, first question is, जिसके पीछे हम लोगों ने बड़े धक्के खाए हैं, is it possible to buy second home with less than 20% down in Canada?
That's a good question you asked, Shilpa. Actually, most of the people think that they cannot. Okay.
We also but, think we cannot.
There is a possibility to do that because any property more than 1 million, you have to pay 20%. So
yeah.
That is a second or first or whatever it is.
Okay, so even for first time home buyers, if you're buying a property for more than million,
then it must be 20% down.
Okay.
So, you have a property and that property is not under the insurance. That's CMSC, I mean,
yes, Canada, yes.
If it is not in that insurance, for example, you have a property that's in the insurance and you want to buy another property, what people do is they will refinance this property, so automatically this is out of that insurance and the new property they'll pay a minimum down payment and buy that.
So if your first property is not under CHMC,
yeah,
you can buy the second property and have two properties and you can buy second property in less than 20%.
Yeah.
Wow, okay. So that question was asked by Barkha. So Barkha, I hope you got the answer that when you're buying a second property or first property should not be in insurance with CMHC and you can still buy with less than 20%. We couldn't do that. Okay. So you know all the history and everything, but we'll go with the second question. Second question is, a lot of people have asked, can people on work permit or on student permit buy property in Canada? And if yes, what are the differences? If the interest rate would be different for them, if they will pay higher taxes, or they should wait until they are PR or citizens?
Yeah, if any person, if they are not PR or Canadian citizen, that means work permit or student visa, those people, work permit, they have to pay NRST, a non-resident
non-resident tax. Yeah.
So that is 25% now. So for example, if you're buying a property worth 600K, whatever down payment you are paying, other than that, you have to pay 150K extra.
To as the taxes? Lawyer.
Yeah, as tax. So you'll get that money back when you became a PR or citizen.
Oh, okay.
Okay. You can get that money back. But after that, but there's a time frame for that too. And these things are keep on changing.
Is it only for students for work permit?
For students, you cannot work permit.
Only for work permit.
Yeah.
How about students? Can they buy property?
No, there is no program right now.
So they cannot buy the property. So now I will take Shivika Anand Sharma's question. And her question is buying condo worth it or one should buy a land house? Probably she's thinking of buying her first house in Canada and she's confused whether to buy a condo or buy a land house.
It depends, like for example, if someone is buying, there will be a limit for them. This is the price I can afford.
Yep.
And they have an area, like this is the area I have to buy. Sometimes they can only afford the condos in that area, then they cannot buy. Because everyone wants to buy something on the land,
yes,
like in the sense of town. So something they want to buy. Why they are buying a condo? No one prefers condo. But because of their financial situation, they can only afford that one. That's the reason.
But what are the benefits of condo? Who live in condo and don't want to buy a land house, what could be the reason that they so love condo?
The thing is winter time.
In Canada, you can see.
There's a winter time too, so you know, from the Amit underground parking, you can just take the vehicle and go. But you know, if you are living in a land like a driveway, morning you have to shovel everything, and
you know,
then you will think that okay, I should have
bought a condo. And the people, when they are on the verge of retirement, when they are only living together like husband and wife and kids have gone, that time probably security, single parent.
Shilpa, you said it right. We start in an apartment, condo, townhouse, more bigger house,
yeah.
Custom home, and eventually you will go back to a condo.
Condo. Yeah, that's a life cycle. You will start with a condo, you will end up in a condo at the later stage of your life. So you have to cycle that. Yeah. So I always say that in summers, people who live on the land houses with backyard and the front yards, we say, hey, condo people, we have backyard and the front yard. And on winters, they say, oh, you have to shovel snow, we have parked garage. Okay, so I'll take next question of Sonal Mishra. She has real estate license and she's asking that I have a full-time job and a real estate license. What are your tips to grow in the field as a beginner when somebody wants to make their career as real estate agent? And on that note, Vraj Mendapara has asked, what I need to do to be a real estate agent?
It's a big question actually. You don't have an objective type of answer for that one. But the first thing, because the real estate, I always tell people, it's a trust-based business. It's not like any other sales.
Yeah.
They are one of the biggest investment in their life. They have to trust you to do that.
Yeah.
Okay. So the trust, it won't come automatically. People can teach you how, but you have to carry yourself well in that.
Yeah.
Okay. Any business or any work, anything they do, there's a starting point.
Yes.
So each day they are learning and improving themselves.
Yes, I guess relationships work a lot. If you have good relationships with people, good networking with people, this is the only way to get successful in real estate business.
You can do 1,000 advertisement, everything, but the first advertisement, your service. What kind of service you are providing? Because if you are doing a good service, they will recommend you to their friends. That's how you are growing your business. Advertisement, everything shows that you are strong in the market. That's the only thing. But your business will go mouth publicity. That's the first thing you have to see.
And for Varad's question, what courses I need to do to pursue real estate, I have a full video on that. I'll put the video link in the description box. Okay, next question, again Komal Chandelji, what are the chances of rate of interest going down? Iske liye to waise mujhe kisi mortgage wale bande ka interview lena chahiye tha, but phir bhi, keeping today's time when rate of interest are going up, and this is the future of real estate in next 5 years. Do you think that real estate business will go down, the prices will go down, this is not the right time to buy a property in Canada or invest a property in Canada? What do you think will happen in real estate now?
Any business, any sales business is a supply and demand. Demand is going to go up because that many people are coming to this country.
Yes.
And the majority of them are coming in two places. One is Toronto, another one is Vancouver.
Yes.
Because why they are going to stick here? Because there they can get jobs and everything. So that's why they are staying here. The rental rate is going to go high.
Yes.
When that is going to go up, the investors are going to buy everything. So first time buyers won't get any houses. Okay. It's going to be very tricky in Canada to explain about how the market is going to behave. For example, in January, my video, I said that after April, market will go up. And that it, even that time people said, you know, inflation is that one. I said no, people's mindset here is like that. They'll sit there for 4 or 5 months and if it is okay, they'll move on. That's how Canadian mindset is.
Yes.
Okay. Because interest rate didn't change, like from January till now, now only June only, that they increased 0.25%. But before it was same, but still market gone up. 4 or 5 months, they'll wait. They wait in the fence, but after that, they'll move on.
There is a question somebody has asked, whether to rent a house right now or buy a house right now and wait and watch what the market is doing.
It's a choice you make. Choice is like you want to pay someone else mortgage or your own mortgage. If you have to save money each month, rental is better, I would say. Because instead of paying $4,000, you can rent it for $2,500 and you can save $1,500 a month. But the thing is, long plan, 2-3 years, if you buy a property, that appreciation itself will give you that kind of money.
That question was asked by Kitika, by the way. And TM has asked that now Toronto market has been saturated, the rates of the houses have gone up and everybody's moving to Calgary. So do you think Calgary would be next Toronto, where it is wise to invest in Calgary and then after 2-3 years it will be next Toronto giving the positive cash flow?
Yeah. Actually, why people are moving to Calgary? Because they couldn't afford housing.
Yes, they could afford a house there, yes.
But in Canada also, the outskirts, you can afford the area. Like, for example, St. Catharines or Peterborough, you can afford properties there, even 500,000, 600,000. Good properties are there. But I don't know why people are moving.
Because to Calgary.
Actually, I'm also from India. Like, someone is moving from India to here. From here to Calgary is not too far.
Yes.
Simple
yes,
as that. But
yes.
That's a personal choice. But weather is the only big issue there. So that's why when people are going there, I'll say, okay, see you in a couple of years. We have one more deal here.
Maybe they're like, okay, Calgary is still a city. Rather than moving to Peterborough or St. Catharines and feeling we have come to a village, they still will feel, oh, we are in a city. But a city with harsh winters. So you have to make your choice right. Jitendra Luthra ji has asked, do you think the current situation and the situation we had in 1981, I don't even want to think about it, because in 1981 we had interest rates gone up till 20%. We all will like sell our houses if the interest rate will go up till 20% nowadays. Do you think it will be turning the next 1981?
No.
Thank you. I'm satisfied with just no, but you can elaborate.
Main thing, like one thing, election 2025 election is coming, so no government is going to do that.
Thank you. Yeah. Every year there should be an election.
No, the thing is the people cannot afford the property. Market, it will crash. So government won't do that.
Government won't make the market crash, I guess. There are a lot of people on my channel who are first-time home buyers and they want to know if there are any government programs related to first-time home buyers. How Canadian market is supporting first-time home buyers?
There's a program right now, like if you are putting 5% down payment, government will support 5%. Even if you are putting 10% down, government will support 10%.
So, and if you are putting 15% down?
No.
Okay.
Maximum 10 only.
Maximum 10%. Yeah. Okay.
And for that, some catches are there. In the sense, in Toronto, household income must be within 150K.
Okay.
Outside Toronto, it can be like because that's a federal program. So, Toronto or Vancouver, it's and outside these places, it is 120K household income. Okay. So, 120 outside Toronto, Vancouver, it is 4 times. You can buy 120 means 4 times of that one. That is 480.
So, 480. Yeah. So, you can buy a house up till 480.
And
10% government will pay if you are paying 10%.
Yeah. And when you are selling that property, you have to pay that 10%, and appreciation amount 8% you have to pay them as well.
Pay the government. Yeah. Okay. That's a nice program. I didn't even know about it, that if you are buying a house as a first time home buyer, but the catch is you should get a property in 480. Like if I talk about Ontario, we have houses in less than 480 nowadays.
Yeah, you can buy properties. Like you have to go a little more outer. A couple of years back I was recommending them Peterborough. So appreciation percentage was really high in there.
Yes.
Like a 30-40% appreciation there. So we can always recommend those kind of places where the next appreciation is going to be.
Safura Faisal has asked, what are the areas to consider where houses are still cash flow positive? Because to be true, nowadays, any investment property with the current rate of interest, houses are not cash flow positive. So she wants to know what are the areas that she can invest where still cash flow positive houses are there.
Yeah, you said it right, Shilpa, because it's so hard to get a cash positive cash flow
nowadays.
Property. But you can get it if you are doing a student rental or bachelor rental. So you can get a positive cash flow.
Which places?
Near to any college.
Any, okay.
For example, here I can recommend like Peterborough or Welland or like nearby the colleges, if you buy like and a student rental, there are people, property management companies are there. So you can tell them like, okay, this is the property, I need monthly this much money from you. And whether they are giving to 10 kids or 15 kids, that's not your headache. Every month you will be getting that money.
So this government schemes for first-time home buyers, this will only be applicable when you are buying a property for yourself as a primary resident, not for investment
property. Primary residence only.
Now let's talk about selling the property. Do you think it is the right time to sell the investment property if you have?
like
if these are cash flow negative, or people should wait and retain their negative cash flow properties and wait for some miracle to happen and market to change, and there will be some, because nowadays what is happening, people are paying more for their mortgage and they're getting less rental income. So what should those home buyers who have investment properties do?
Yeah, actually if there's a negative cash flow, then they have to see like how much negative it is. And 1 year they have to take, for example, $1,000. That means yearly you are going to get a hit of $12,000.
Yes.
So if you just wait for a year and appreciation is going to be $25,000, just
yeah.
Even January, because there was a little bit hike in May, you know, like then it appreciated almost 8% at that time. But you know, even that small percent itself will give you a 25,000 or 30,000, more than that one appreciation. You're only taking a hit of 12,000. But if
yes.
you wait one more year, you can gain that money in another way.
But do you think the house prices will still go up? Like we are thinking that there will be another rate interest hike.
In 20 years, I've seen this one 5-6 times. Market going up and really crashing down, even 2008, 2009. I was a realtor at that time too. But you know, 4 years when you take it, always it is up. In between it will go like this, like, but in your 4 years, it will be from here to here, up only.
Yeah, but the kind of hike in the prices we have seen from 2019 to 2021, that was like extreme.
Next to 5-6 years, I can guarantee one thing, like you are not going to see like a 20-25% hike what we had a couple of years back and all. That won't happen. Normal appreciation will be there, but that kind of a really crazy hike won't be there. Shilpa, we offer one more thing for our sellers as well, because most of the properties when we visit, it is not in a good shape. But the seller, most of the sellers won't have money to do the renovation.
Yeah.
So what we normally do is, because we know exactly what are the things we have to do in that property, flooring, painting, these are not a major reconstruction or nothing like that.
Yep.
It's a, facelift, we'll say, like a, for example, flooring, painting and these kind of, and a countertop, these kind of kitchen updates or washroom updates. So up to 25,000, we give that money to them, or our contractors will come and do that job. They can pay that money back after the sale happens, after complete sale. They can pay that money.
Wow, that's really nice. Like you are investing. What if the property is still not sold? You have invested 25,000 on somebody's property. What will you do in that case?
No, because that is where the experience matters. We will give that guarantee to them, like because when you do these things, we can sell it. Because,
okay.
Because around the price range also we will give them. Like we can, max we can get this, or minimum we can get this one. And if we are not selling, we can always discuss and decide that one. And anyway, it's good for that seller as well, no?
It is good for seller for sure.
Yeah.
If you are sitting on your negative cash flow properties and want to sell, they will invest the money like on your property to redecorate it. Last question before we come to the Canadian Home app features, and I'll tell you why you should have this app on your phone. Can you advise us some tips and tricks of the people who are dreaming of buying their first home, how to save money and like what all they can do to save that down payment?
First and foremost, they have to really look into their credit score. So I mean, people do think, okay, that phone bill I'm not paying that one, because they do have argument with them, and credit score will go down, and
yeah.
You know, that's the foremost thing, like first and foremost credit score, okay.
Yep.
Other things, saving money is like people always go with the luxurious rental places, and they spend. But you must have a plan. In a year I will buy a thing, and right now I have to save money, means just a rental, they have to control that rental money and do that living. They can every day save money and do that. Like
that's true.
The minimum down payment, most of the clients, like they do second jobs, and because first home is the hardest one. After
yes.
that it is so easy.
Okay? True that.
And even back home, those properties they don't need to sell.
Yes.
They can refinance that one and bring money here and buy that.
Yes.
We always guide them really well how to do that one. And which route they have to take, that's up to them.
Yeah.
Okay. Don't think you're on and do that one. Just come with us and have a discussion. And then in a year or 6 months or one thing, they can buy that one. But they must know which route they have to take.
Yeah. Okay, now tell me how the Canadian Home app is different than other apps in the market.
So you can answer that question.
Oh, I have already told you that why. Because why it is my favorite app. I love this app because first of all, it has multi-city search. Like, okay, if I'm looking for a house to buy or a rent in 3-4 cities and I'm comparing the cities, there's an option that you can do it. Live chat feature is good, but chatting with your partner is also very good. Sometimes what happens when you are looking for a house, like 3 houses you want to show to your partner and then discuss about that house, there is an in-app, like in-app feature, chat feature, where with every house you can chat with your partner on that particular house and you can save all the chat history related to particular house in that app. Other thing which I like is you have school rating in the app, which is not there in most of the apps. There are few apps which have school rating, but here, whether you're renting a house or buying a house, you can see the school rating. It's a very user-friendly app, I would say. Plus, there are features like if there is a property in the market which is not sold for 30 days, there is a different column for that. Like on homepage, you can see what are the properties which are not sold in 30 days. You can simply go there and see, okay, these are the properties not sold in 30 days. Maybe there is a negotiation power you can use and buy the property in less price. Then there are properties which have reduced their prices in recent times. So you can see, like, on homepage you have all the features. You don't need to juggle up with the different features or different, I would say, filters. All the filters you can find at one place. So that makes users' experience using your app very good. And nowadays I have only one app at my phone.
Small, simple things also, like which level the washrooms are, like yes, even minor things also be taken care of.
In fact, I was speaking to the CEO of this the Canadian Home before the starting this interview, and they were telling me that they have invested great deal of money in research before launching this app, and it shows. It definitely shows. Thank you so much, Mr. Manoj. It was very nice coming to this place and having this discussion. I hope mere sare subscribers ko questions ka answer mil gaye honge. Mere bahut sare doubts clear hue. अगर आपके कुछ क्वेश्चंस थे जो मैं टाइम कंस्ट्रेंट की वजह से नहीं ले पाई इस वीडियो में, आप प्लीज़ मुझे कमेंट्स करके बताओ. आई मेक श्योर कि या तो मैं या फिर कैनेडियन होम ऐप की कोई भी जो हमारे पास है, इनका बहुत ही अच्छा चैट सपोर्ट है, उनमें से कोई आपके क्वेश्चन के आंसर पक्का करेगा. मैं फिर भी मनोज जी का फोन नंबर डिस्क्रिप्शन बॉक्स में डाल दूंगी. ही इज़ द ब्रोकर ऑफ रिकॉर्ड एंड अ रियल एस्टेट एजेंट इन ऑन्टेरियो फॉर लास्ट 20 ईयर्स. तो अगर आपकी कोई प्लान्स है प्रॉपर्टी खरीदने को लेकर, बेचने को लेकर, या फिर अभी जैसे उन्होंने बताया 25,000 तो वही इन्वेस्ट कर देंगे आपके घर पर अगर आपका घर नहीं बिक रहा है, तो उन सब चीजों को लेकर आप डायरेक्टली भी इनसे टच में आ सकते हो. यू कैन स्पीक टू हिम डायरेक्टली इफ आई हैव नॉट आंसर्ड योर क्वेश्चन इन दिस वीडियो. ऑन दैट नोट, थैंक यू सो मच. अब मैं आपसे मिलती हूँ अगली वीडियो में. तब तक के लिए मैं ख्याल रखना. बाय.
थैंक यू.